Is it gonna be a new game, or is it gonna be a load? Hello, and welcome back to my stream. I'm, gonna play Kingdom Hearts Final Mix on the Kingdom Hearts HD 1.5 ReMIX package for the PlayStation 4. I'm standing up right now, but I'm gonna sit down in just a moment. So who wants to see me just start all over from the beginning and play the beginning again? Is that an idea? Everybody's talking about Morrowind and Oblivion in the chat. Morrowind is better. Like, it's seriously better, everybody. I think we might get off at Destiny Island today. We're gonna have a whole lot of Donald Duck. Yeah, we're gonna be ducking around with Donald Duck today here on Destiny Island. My God, I've been to Destiny Island before. Someone in the chat saying they can't listen because they're busy doing something else. Well, you can listen later. I guess we should go ahead and take a load. Wait, come on. A fade to black just as I press the button. Thinking of you, wherever you are. That's just somebody thinking of somebody. The game is, the game is just letting me know that it likes, let's go ahead and get it. Seaside Shack, KHFM. Welcome back to KHFM. Oh. God, the music just immediately starts having a party. The second you boot the game up, the music is just like, ugh, have a party. It's just like, this music is so intense. It's like you'd think that the last time we left the game, the world was like about to end. Doom, 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 doom. Monsters. Oh yeah, I'm supposed to just not fight them. They're the heartless. I think that they were originally designed as like a metaphor for Final Fantasy fans.
The door. Is open.
The door is open, everybody. All right.
The door is open, Sora.
Yeah,
now
he just repeated himself.
Now we can go to the outside world.
What are you talking about? We've got to find Kairi.
Kairi's coming with us.
So, Riku actually knows for a fact that there is another world. You may have noticed this. He knows there's an outside world. Because he actually remembers being brought here.
We can't let fear stop us. I'm not afraid of the darkness.
Crikey. God, what a declaration, huh?
Riku.
Have you ever yelled that you're not afraid of the darkness? What a manly, like, grown-up declaration for this stalwart young lad. Man, Riku, again, for those who came in late, Riku's a good boy. For those who came in late that's a reference to the ancient comic strip, The Phantom, which was turned into a movie starring Billy Zane. Billy Zane, who voices the character of Ansem. Oh my God, there it is! Only one boy holds the key. Literally. So one of the reasons I'm streaming this is so that I have some footage to throw in behind my... video that I'm working on. The video is done. It just at present lacks footage. I was playing Birth by Sleep earlier today. And you want to know, Kingdom Hearts fans, the world over, they all seem to think that Birth by Sleep is not the best. But the combat in it is like really like legit good. I don't know. I kind of like it. I really want some abilities, god darn it. Birth by Sleep, like at the very beginning, it's just like dishing out abilities, because it's like brimming with confidence that the only reason you would be playing that game is because you like Kingdom Hearts. It's just, I mean, this is the beginning of an adventure, so it's not, I don't have any abilities, any like blocking or dodge yet. Well, Sora getting up in the air a little bit. It's a little dark, it's a little muddy right now. I'm just gonna keep fighting these dudes because I hate them and I want my experience points. Oh, Krikerino. Oh, hey, he came on down to join the party, that's good. I guess I can try locking on. There's no use locking on when the enemies don't. I got my tech point. The enemies aren't even, like, doing me the courtesy of attacking me. Anyway, this is what combat in Kingdom Hearts is like. I've made fun of Kingdom Hearts combat before, but it's actually pretty good. Oh, I was just playing Birth by Sleep where the L2 and R2 change your abilities. You're on your skill deck over there. Though, in this, you have to use the L2 and R2 to change your targets, to cycle targets. You can use a... I mean, I like to use the D-pad for my skills anyway, but in Birth by Sleep, I was using the triggers. I'll tell you what, that remaster of Birth by Sleep is like 60 FPS as heck, dude. It is so 60 FPS. Anyway, I think I've killed enough of these. No, I haven't, because I just got a potion. Lord, freaks. All I need is some magic, just a little bit of magic. And I need my sidestep maneuver. Crikey. I mean, I just like this simple, dumb combat. Okay, I'm gonna not... God, these tasties just refill me immediately. I'm gonna go ahead and get to... Oh my god, get to where I'm... Oh my lord. He just did not want to walk up that goddarn staircase. I'm supposed to go back to the seaside shack. Or wherever. So yeah, I like the more... I think when the Kingdom Hearts combat starts getting completely complicated, it becomes like a really, like, design...
Sora.
Game designerly interesting video game. Because some of that combat stuff in KH2 is just wild. It's just bonkers as heck. Oh! Little boy hug denied. You got owned. Yeah, I've chosen to have my leveling happen at the end game. Okay, so this guy, not only does he not have a heart, when he did have a heart, it was in his stomach. They say the fastest way to a man's heart is through his stomach. They weren't kidding. I don't know what that means. It's Friday, everybody. Who's the... Oh, am I just dead? Guy gets down to half HP before he starts screaming off alarms. I have to be down to, like, 6% HP before I call a doctor. You know? In real life. I'm talking about real life. Can you imagine if there was an app, if some sleazebag made, like, some sort of health sensor app that, like, basically had, like, your life meter on it? I mean, I've got my Apple Watch. It's constantly got my heart rate. It's telling me what my heart rate is. Though it's like, what if somebody, like, sleazeballed together, like, a whole bunch of biometrics and then just had, like, a life meter app so I could look at my wrist and, like, know my life expectancy. Oh, crikey. Oh, yeah, give me that cheese. What? We have a legibility problem here with this guy. Man, yeah, so just playing, like, an hour of that Birth by Sleep combat, it's so much more legible. Because the series decided it was more about the design stuff, I guess, by that point, by that, like, late hour. It's just like, yeah, we know that you love fighting monsters and leveling stuff up, and the Keyblade lore is, like, such a deal at that point. And it's, like, it's so much easier to see. Everything's, like, it's really super, like... combat friendly. It's like they know you're here for some sweet combat. One of the nice things about having so few HP this early in the game is this guy's blocking my hits. What a chump. Is you can just refill your HP real fast. Yeah, you're getting wasted, punk. All I want is some ability. And yeah, I'm playing this on the PS4. I love playing it on the PS4. These cutscenes flip back into 30 FPS. But you know what? I don't mind. I don't mind that the cutscenes are 30 FPS. Because that still has frame rate advantage over Ooh. Disney films. Oh my god, Goofy! Donald!
Ooh, a star is going out!
Ooh! You idiot! Again, everybody has a Goofy voice, but nobody has a Donald Duck voice. And if you have a Donald Duck voice, it's bad. Last time we were talking about how Scrooge McDuck is literally in Kingdom Hearts 3, Traverse Town. I like Traverse Town. You know what I like about Traverse Town? And I'm going to say this. It's going to sound like I'm being mean.
Might even find Leon.
Leon is... that's actually Squall from Final Fantasy. I like how Goofy is referred to second personed as a palooka. Now, Goofy hanging out with Pluto is weird. I'm sorry, it's unusual. A talking dog and then a non-talking dog? The first of many, sudden translations that this boy will encounter. He now has no recollection of getting to a completely different world. You gotta imagine, it's a goddarn hyperbaric chamber, lucid dream, trip out bad boy experience that Sora has for pretty much his whole life. He just...
Do you know where we are?
He just does not have a cool life at all. His life is just a constant fireworks display of disasters. All right. Man, also, again, I hate to keep harping on Birth by Sleep, but it's so fresh in my memory. The slow walk that Ventus has in Birth by Sleep at the beginning, the animation is really, really good. It's like top-tier AAA 3D animation. Top-tier. And it's like his feet move like exactly... in step with the distance he's traveling. It's like super perfect. Now, Kingdom Hearts 1... Oh, get a good chill tune here. Again, all this music is remastered in this PS4 remaster, so it's not the same, like, weird plonky, bleepy bloopy middies that were in the first one. They weren't that bleepy bloopy, but it's like super chill. I'm just gonna walk around a little bit. So the reason his shoes are so big is this is... Actually, this game was a really big deal when it first came out. There actually was no right analog stick camera movement in the PS2 original. So, 3D games, at least, especially if this scope, were quite rare. So, his feet are really big so that you... Or his shoes are really big so that you always know where his feet are. Being able to sense a character's feet is... it is the key to... actually feeling like you're part of a 3D space in a video game. Tomonobu Itagaki has talked at length about this in the Ninja Gaiden game for Xbox original and then Ninja Gaiden 2. He talked a lot about feet. A lot about just always being able to sense where the character's feet are. Knowing where the character's feet are constantly and having like good visually signaling feet in a 3D game is essential to preventing motion sickness. Believe it or not, it grounds the eyes. It pulls the eyes into something. And pulling the eyes into where the ground is actually works a lot better to combat the brain's natural vertigo impulses. So, fun fact. You know, a little bit. That's why his feet are so big. But I think his walk cycle bothers me a little bit because maybe it's the size of his shoes, but it seems like he takes too many steps. And so what I really like about Traverse Town, the first environment you get to really, really chill in Kingdom Hearts. And again, this is going to sound like a backhanded criticism, but it's not. It feels like... It actually feels like I'm in Disneyland. You know? Because of the way these walls are, it feels like I'm in some sort of a cardboard cutout, sort of a fake place, you know? Currently closed off. Punks. I've got my key and I've left the island, everybody, but I have not met Donald Duck yet. All I need is Donald. We're gonna go get him. Who wants Donald? Oh my god, I can get a cup of coffee. Oh my god, I just, like, so... When I booted up Birth by Sleep, because I'm working on this this video, right? And I'm working on making this video, and I just I'm capturing the opening cutscenes of every Kingdom Hearts game that's on this collection, and I'm just using those as the background for my video, because the idea is just my video's just chill. You're just gonna listen to me talk about Kingdom Hearts for about 12 minutes or so. That's basically the gist. I'm gonna tell you what it means to me. So I'm just watching the intro to Birth by Sleep, and I got these headphones on, and I'm just sitting here, and I'm just like, this is wild, dude. I just love it. I just, like, I genuinely love that I can just chill with the game. And, okay, the three districts. Oh, the mailbox with the tongue. Anyway, this game's just goofy as heck. Literally. Oh, is this just Tidus with, like, different, like a palette swap to Tidus? People with nowhere else to turn come to this town. Everyone here has an unhappy past. Sounds like she's talking about Earth, huh? What is that like to have a happy past? Do you know anybody like that? Narcs. That's what I say. Okay, I'm just chilling. Don't worry, I'm gonna go into the accessory shop. Oh, Cid Highwind! Man, it would rule if every Cid is in Kingdom Hearts. Like, every single Cid. Told me to simmer down. Why the long face, Sora? You a horse? Huh? Gramps! Don't call me Gramps. Okay, I'm pretty sure in Japanese he called him, like, O-san or Oji-san. Or Oji-san. Or O-san. Sure ain't your island. Having to look up and then down at the screen, like, for these text titles, when, like, one, you press the button and then the one you're looking at doesn't change. The bigger your TV, the more confusing that would be. Oh, yeah. Give me that cheese. Mithril shard. I like shards. Ah, man. I'm just playing this and I'm like, I guess I do kind of want to play all of this game. But also, having collected that first shard, I'm just like, I want to play Kingdom Hearts 2. Because all that weird customizability stuff in Kingdom Hearts 2. All this stuff is just... Kingdom Hearts 2 is stuff wild. It's just straight up stuff wild. Oh, here's Huey, Dewey, and Big Boy, as I call him. I wanted to just talk to them because they're my friends. Well, that's it? The only thing he has to say is... Our shop has all sorts of stuff for sale. You don't want to say anything else to me? Okay, I don't actually need any of your trash, child. That's weird. So, you know, he actually points at a very present issue in people's lives. His job is keeping the shop clean, but that doesn't mean he keeps his bedroom clean. We can seldom be trusted to do what we are paid to do. Unless we're getting paid to do it. This is why, like, 90% of personal chefs, professional, I messed up my own joke. This is why, like, 90% of professional chefs die of starvation. Because they don't cook for themselves. That's why barbers never get haircuts. Yeah. The one they just import money for from Winnie the Pooh. That's, I guess that's a thing. So, my strongest memory of Kingdom Hearts is the whole "Where do I go?" Just like not knowing where I'm supposed to go. Crikey. It's currently closed off. So I've explored the town, and now I want to get out of the town. I need to get out of town for a while. You know what I mean? He's like, is he high? Look at his eyes. He looks like half asleep. So I remember Kingdom Hearts 2 just being like a rope, just solid, just like always like not so much telling you where to go all the time as you just kind of always like intuit where to go. I mean, the game is telling you where to go, but you feel like it's your idea. This game, on the other hand, straight up just does not tell you nothing. But that's the authentic Japanese role-playing game experience. So in that way, Kingdom Hearts feels kind of like this weird, this like super weird leveled up 16-bit RPG. I just accidentally went into the item shop again. Huey, Dewey, and Louie are narcs because they don't, I'm sure they would narc me out. I like how their item shop has consistent geometry. Actually, I think the stairs inside are shorter than these stairs here. We could go count. We could definitely count. A lot of people in the chat keep asking what system this is being played on. It's being played on a PS4. It's widescreen and it's a solid 60 FPS on the PS4. On the PS3, it's not quite so rock solid. Oh, here's where.
Oh, gosh.
Oh, your heart got took, punk. No, straight blasted. So this is where Kingdom Hearts really becomes Kingdom Hearts. They're not creatures, they're heartless. So, it's a curious design choice, and I mean this as like a really high compliment, to have a battle system where enemies scatter HP restorative items almost like 100% of the time. And they're scattered and, like, unlike games such as God of War, other games that were getting highly praised at around this time, they don't magnetize into you. You have to actually go pick them up. So you have to divide what I call your business as a player. The division of business. Does everybody know the acting term business? It's a theater term. Business means if it's said that a director is giving an actor business, it means they're telling the actor to like do stuff. They're like famously Quentin Tarantino asks actors to eat in almost all of his movies, like gives them a meal and asks them to like actually eat it. That's business. So in Kingdom Hearts, the battle system is very chill and relaxed. It's not super, the music is all pumping and wild, but that's only to just put you in the mood. But the game just gives you, it gives you an opportunity to divide your attention up. And that has an illusion of making it feel like you have a lot of stuff to do. Now, I'm talking about early in the game. Later in the game, there's legitimately a bunch of strategic stuff like that you're actually required to make interesting decisions during battles, and it's fun. Even though Donald Duck dies like 99% of the time. Oh, yeah. So, Basically, it's just, you know, I can go get some of those. I don't really need any of that life, or it's like if my life meter's only a tiny bit empty, I can, like, run over and grab some. I just love getting money. It's just businessy. I can hit these dudes or I can pick things up. That's what I'm saying. Okay, no. So I remember, I have this distinct, like, sharp memory of playing Kingdom Hearts 1 and getting solid infuriated at the battle system at this point. Because, like, the first time enemies start... Oh, shut up. I need my life. There's another green ball over there. You know, I feel like Dark Souls having the enemy lock on be on a trigger or on a stick click is kind of clunky. I like that this game has a lock on the R1 button. I think that's nice and sweet. Oh, more?
Come on.
However, I mean, Dark Souls can't get away with that because it uses shoulder buttons for attacks. It uses shoulder and the trigger. When I play, I've been playing Dark Souls remastered on my Xbox One X recently because it's in 4K and 60 FPS, which is, like, incredible. And I'm playing it on my Elite controller. I'm supposed to meet Donald Trump. I've been playing it on my Elite controller, and I have one bumper, the left bumper on the left, the big left, or not bumper, but flippers, the paddles. The big left flipper is for shield. To hold my shield up. And the little right bumper. I keep saying bumper. The little right paddle is for lock on. And the large right paddle is for dodge. And that way I never have to take my fingers off the sticks. Or I never have to use the stick for anything aside from camera adjustment. I'm supposed to go in this building, right? It's like the Dalmatian house. No? Ah! Keep missing them. Humph. Yeah, I'd like to hear Donald Duck try to say humph, right? I don't think he could say that with that shape of mouth that he has. Oh my god, this is so 65th. Man.
Come on.
Narratively, he is yet perplexed and confused by the nature of these creatures. So I feel like he's not yet earned the maturity gumption to yell, come on, at these guys. The narrative has yet to portray him as deserving of confidence. All I want is some sort of defensive maneuver that I can perform to feel smart. I just want to level up, though. I just want Donald and Goofy to level up with me because they're my best friends. Oh, stop. I'll eat one of these little green burgers. Oh, man. These guys really want me to taste the rainbow, huh? I just want Donald Duck to talk to me. I've decided that Sora is me. Are these battles not optional? I'm fighting them just because I like watching stuff die. Crikey. Oh, I got a lucid shard, everybody. Man, he's really putting those clown shoes on the floor this fight, isn't he? Okay, you want to just get turned into a piece of punk garbage? I feel like I could just go, and these guys wouldn't care. No. Oh my god, I'm just like wasting them all. These guys are gonna have to get a lot better at punking dudes if they wanna fight me. Hey, we did it, everybody. We won the battle. Give me that cash. If they didn't want me taking their cash, they shouldn't have left it all over the floor. What? Oh, heck oh. Climb that ladder, bro. Kinda wobbly. Guess I can't climb it now. Are you wilding out? Just climb it, idiot. Oh, this is the Dalmatian's house. Oh, these idiots. Yeah, this could take a while. All I want is to hug Donald. The 99 puppies were lost amid the chaos of their world's destruction. Find them in various worlds. So this is one of the things that originally kind of weirded me out about Kingdom Hearts 1 was I come in here and here's some Disney characters and it's like, heck yeah, Disney characters. And then it's like, oh, I'm not talking to them and I'm not seeing their story, but a pop-up dialogue box is just like, yeah, you see these two dogs? They had a world and it was destroyed, and it was destroyed in a chaos, and amid that chaos they lost their 99 puppies. That coffee is not good. Find them in various worlds. That's it. So here's where you, the player, make a choice. Is do you, as Sora? So far, Sora has not looked at the Dalmatians. He has not laid his eyes on them yet. He is still staring dead forward at me, accusingly. As though I did this, as though I killed 99 puppies. So you, the player, make a choice. This is where it becomes a role-playing game. Does Sora even look at the Dalmatians, or does he just walk away? Because to him, it's not about saving the puppies for glory. He doesn't want their thanks. All he wants is just, you know, he's just going to do what's right when the opportunity to do something right occurs to him. So, yeah. I have a lot of issues with Sora's jump in Kingdom Hearts 1. We got to see some of those last time I played this game the other day. On Wednesday, I was hilariously failing to make simple jumps. Because basically all it takes for you to forget what the jumping is like in Kingdom Hearts is to just not play Kingdom Hearts 1 for a couple of years. The jumping is like, he like works his jump. He does a lot of work in this jump. Like, you see how high up his knees go? Gives the illusion of a... I mean, it looks like he's jumping really, like, way higher than he actually is. I want to go in that vacant house. That's what I'm going to do tonight. I'm going to go back to the vacant house that I squat in. I don't squat in a vacant house. I pay rent. I pay rent to some sleazebag who was probably born owning 10 apartment buildings, just like everybody else in this city does. Let's take a look in this vacant house. Well, I live here now. So if I were Sora, I wouldn't be all sad about losing my beach world. I would be like, I'm just gonna chill. I'm just gonna get drunk in here. Someone in the chat said, eat all landlords. That's not what I'm saying. But I do want to point out, have you ever thought of a sleazier job than landlord? I mean, that's weird, man. You just own a house And then when something is broken in the house and the person who lives there calls, you just don't answer the phone ever. I mean, that's an easy job. When there's just like no heat in the house, because just for some reason the heat's been turned off and all the tenants are probably calling you all day, you just like put your phone on silent, keep watching porno on your laptop or whatever it is you do. Gotta say, oh, there's Lady and the Tramp. Someone in the chat who's more knowledgeable about this than I am, tell me, is there another Lady and the Tramp reference in the Kingdom Hearts series? Do I ever get to meet Lady and the Tramp, or is this it? Are they just the inspiration for a spaghetti-themed fountain, which somehow lacks even spaghetti? There's no spaghetti on that plate. There's no spaghetti on the plate. Welcome back to my Kingdom Hearts critical playthrough. Where's all the spaghetti? What? What? These Heartless are... I mean, they're cruel, to be sure. Something blue on the ground, that's good. You know, as far as the... Oh my god, I learned sliding dash. That's the technique I wanted. Let's actually go. Oh my god, he's just clown. He's just, look at him just clomping on down Clown Street. Just clomping on down. We're gonna go ahead and give him sliding dash. We're gonna equip it. Yeah, do it. Alright, okay, it's on. Or is it? Ah, oh, heck. Yeah, that's right. Okay, hold on. I finally leveled up. First district. Alright, let's go through here. Huh? Well, you're holding a huge key, bro. He's holding a massive key. He could just, like, jam it in there. I bet it would work. Now look at this very helpful map. One is connected to two, and two is connected to one. But only one is connected to three, and three is connected to a flame. That kind of just tells you the whole thing, doesn't it? People in the chat are telling me Sora's pretty stupid. Yeah. I guess I figured that. No, I don't want to go back into the vacant house. As far as first RPGs go, or first RPG dungeons go, this is pretty good. Because you're just hanging out in this weird Disneyland cardboard town. And there's monsters splashing out at you. Huh? Yeah, hit him. Oh, crikey. I genuinely love not knowing what to do. Oh, that's currently closed off as well. That takes me to the fire district. I'm in district 3 now. Man, like, the gumption of this game. It doesn't have a mini map or anything. It's just like, shut up, noob. It's just, I mean, it's just attacking me with its, level geometry here. I'm at a loss. I'm gonna try to go back. But where is back? Oh my god. Okay, that's vacant house. Okay, this is the second district. I know that I meet Donald and Goofy here. I've just played some... Oh, you punks. I've played so much of this particular video game series that... It's humble beginnings, sir. You know, they're gone with the ether. Is that an expression, gone with the ether? The battle music just flows in and out. Oh, I don't need you. Nice purses. Can't go in there. I guess this very first challenge of Kingdom Hearts 1 is which doors are doors. So when we last saw them, Donald and Goofy, they were exiting this building, right? The Tinker Toy Gizmo Shop or whatever it's called. I don't need you. Oh yeah, I can't go up because it's wobbly. He fears anything wobbly. This guy. This heckin' guy. I've already been in Dalmatian's house. Crikey. Crikey. This is wild. How can I not figure out what to do? Suits and dresses. I'm being told there might be a different door for the Dalmatian house. I've gone into the hotel. Okay, please get out. Which door did I come in? Oh, this one. This is wild. Again, I've only played this game once, and it was literally 17 years ago. Currently closed off. Okay. Okay, wait, so now there's Heartlesses in here, where previously there were not. So there's no people anymore. People are gone. People are gone. What's up? Take another look around town. Sid really just doesn't want to hang out with me. Oh yeah, this
they'll
is a...
They'll come at you out of nowhere.
Who are you?
And they'll keep on coming at you. As long as you continue to wield the Keyblade.
Oh yeah, what would you know about a blade with
but
another
why?
Noun
why
attached
would it choose
to
a kid
it?
Like you?
Hey, what's that supposed to mean?
Never
what?
Mind.
I don't know.
Now, let's see that Keyblade.
What?
The exchange of what's
there's
that
no
supposed
way
to mean and
this.
Never mind.
All
that
right.
Kind of summarizes JRPGs.
Then have it your way.
That's pretty much the same as what's that supposed to mean? I don't know. Oh, I love how it's the same battle music. All right, Squall Leonhardt. You know, I would... So, again, I don't want to sound snippy, but I would play a game like in which I played as this dude. Like, Squall. Like, that's the kind of hero I want in a video game. And I understand that later Kingdom Hearts games pretty much are that. You play as just these super bad butt dudes. I got a tech point. Ooh, I hit you in the knees. Alright, idiot. I guess I could have shot. He just used his fire spell. I could have reflected that back on. Crikerino! Don't kill me, Squall. So.
Here!
Oh man, he got snapped while taking a drink. Oh! Man, he sucks. He doesn't even care enough to take his hand out of his pocket. Oh, you just owned Sora.
I can't believe I died like this.
Oh, well.
Hey, you found it. Nice going, Leon.
Shut up. Don't tell me what's nice going.
I love how Squall and Yuffie are like friends.
It looks like things are worse than we thought.
A lot worse. A lot worse. Oh, yeah. That's how I would voice Squall. I don't care, man. He's dead. That rules. Yeah. Oh, Sora. Yeah. Whatever, man.
It's me, Riku. So sleepy.
Oh my god, Riku is just now just fully ensconced in the abyss of water. We go through all that trouble of building a raft and we don't even get to see ourselves sail on it. What would Chekhov say about this? Looks like Riku's under the sea. His voice is gone. Ursula the Sea Witch has stolen it. He's got really straight, like, blade-like hair. His hair is like... See the way that camera angle makes it look like we're about to enjoy a platforming challenge as that character? It's like level design
gorsh.
Teasing cutscene.
Well, there's nobody here.
A gorsh!
Spooky.
Oh my god, I love that he said gorsh. Uh-oh. Is that Aerith Gainsborough?
Did the king send you?
I can't believe that Aerith would call Mickey Mouse king, that she would bend the knee to Mickey Mouse.
Come on, lazy bum. Wake up.
Hey, don't talk about the work ethic of my bum. Kyrie!
I guess.
Yeah, that's what I would have said. I would have yelled Kyrie real loud. Keyblade.
But it's your heart they really want. Because you wield the Keyblade.
Yeah, I get you.
I'm so glad that you're okay, Kyrie.
Kyrie? Who are you talking about? I'm the great ninja Yuffie.
Uh-oh. Mm-hmm. They really blew it by not pronouncing it Yuffie.
I think you might have overdone it, Squall.
She called him Squall because she's from Final Fantasy.
Don't reveal my Final Fantasy name in front of this boy.
Yeah. We had to get it.
Yuffie's got, I
gotta
say, I'm sorry. I'm sorry to say this, but she's got like wild inguinals. You can see her,
the
inguinals on her abs.
But it won't work for long.
That's a little bit racy.
Still, hard to believe.
Everybody take a look at her abs again. See that? See those inguinals? That shadowing? Nintendo would censor that in the year 2018, at least.
Well, I suppose beggars can't be choosers.
Yeah?
Why don't you start making sense? What's going on here?
Okay.
You oh, here's somebody else.
There are many other worlds out there besides your castle in this town, right?
Yeah. Well, there's supposed to be a secret.
The Final Fantasy voice
actors because
are,
they've never been connected.
They're so low key.
Now,
they sound like real, like normal, like
when the heartless
chill
came,
people.
Everything
changed. And then he goes, "Oh gosh! Oh, oh, oh!"
The ones who attacked you. You remember?
There's like almost no difference between Yuffie and Aerith's voices.
The darkness in people's hearts. That's what attracts them.
Mm-hmm.
And there is darkness within every heart.
Hey,
all right, buddy.
Have you heard of someone named Ansem?
I like how we just saw like Donald Duck like 5 seconds ago. And then
Sam?
There's darkness within
the
every heart. This is narratively innovative
in a very detailed report.
To have these two conversations cut together.
Gosh. Oh, can we see it?
Its pages are scattered everywhere.
Uh-huh. I need the pages.
Too many worlds.
Hundreds. Oh,
ooh,
man, she said too many, not too many.
To find them.
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
Those were my thoughts, exactly.
We've got to find him quick.
We got to find him. Whoa, whoa.
Trust me, Ninja King.
That's right.
I love just beholding the malleability of Donald Duck's bill as it just like flaps and flops like weirdo rubber.
The heartless have great fear of the Keyblade.
Gorsh!
That's why they'll keep coming after you, no matter what.
Well, just imagine, like, Goofy saying, gorsh! After every, like, dark.
Master, and it chose you.
It, like, just
so,
every, like.
Luck.
How did all this happen? I remember being in my room.
Gorsh!
Wait a minute.
Now, Sora's actually like, he perfectly ties together.
Kyrie.
The gorsh and the darkness in every heart. He's like exactly between. He's the bridge between two worlds. The link between them. Is this thing wilding out? That save point's wilding out, dude. I want to go ahead and save it here. Seaside Shack. Never going back. I'm in the green room. Anybody see that film, Green Room? Heck yeah. Directed by Jeremy Saulnier. Fantastic film. Oh, he's just like... She's like relaxed as heck, dude. Just relaxed as heck. Jeremy Saulnier is also the director of the current season of True Detective, which I haven't watched any of yet. I'm waiting for there to be like three episodes, and I'm going to watch three episodes at once. It's dangerous out there. Take this. And then he gives me my Keyblade. Oh, you're not letting me go outdoors? Oh, I'm going to go out this door with the two on it. Is that the one? Man, crikey, bro. You want to tell me what to do instead of telling me what not to do? Yeah, let's go, bro. Yuffie, let's go join Aerith. Oh, the other visitors, okay.
Yuffie, go!
Oh, it's just like the sudden snap from text to voice acting. Let's kill.
Let's go.
Oh my god, I just want Donald Duck and Goofy to become my friends already. Gorsh! Oh my god. He's been turned into paper. Kill the leader to kill the, he just, like, really ran off, didn't he? I'm gonna chill over here for a second. I can't blow those up. Let's go ahead and, what the... Oh my lord. Please, please don't kill me. I'm gonna go in here. I just need my Donald bro back. Yeah, I can't hit them. Man, he's like, find the leader, and it's like, oh, where do I go? Oh, there you are. Oh, just give me that chill tune back. How you doing? Wait, what? I thought you were gonna fight with me. You had your sword out. You just want me to go do stuff? Oh, hecko. Are you gonna tell me where to go? No? Oh, a mega potion? Thanks. Oh, only one potion. How utterly cruel of this game to show Squall whip out his like wild blade and just lead a charge around a corner and then I follow him. Thinking I'm doing so into battle. You use your giant key, dude. Just beat it open. I thought Squall was gonna like carry me into glory, you know? And instead it's just like, yeah, just come on back and if you feel like it later. Crike Arena. Okay. I'm gonna just, this game keeps building me up and then letting me down. Now I know where to go. I have to go to that keyhole that's in that. I know where I'm going now. Someone in the chat says, when there was only one set of footprints, those are the times when Squall said, whatever. Nope, don't need you. I don't want you. I don't need you. hotel. I'm gonna go into the gizmo shop. Because I love the movie Gremlins. Okay. He still doesn't want to go up because it's kind of wobbly. The courageous heart of the savior of the universe right there. Okay. Don't look at the Dalmatians. Go into the living room. Now this is the Dalmatian house where eventually you can get all 101 puppies. Sick, disgusting puppies. By the time you 100% this game, oh, they got a little TV. By the time you 100% this game, this house smells like a slaughterhouse. Oh, you punkos. Okay. Not here, I suppose. Oh, there's that treasure chest I'm not permitted to open yet. I know where I'm supposed to go. It's just I just don't know exactly where it is. Because this level design is kind of a Denny's Kids menu. Oh, there it is. Out of my way, punks. He really uses his full pecs to open that door. Oh, big goof. Goofy's in trouble now.
These the heartless guys?
Yeah, they're gonna kill you, bro. Join me, friends. Oh, that's what I call a mashup. Oh man, Keymaster. Uh-oh. So finally we've got Dono. Big Don. Don boy. Blasted chump. Now I'm ready to kill all the monsters. Oh hey guys, whoa. If you guys wanted to, you could pick up some of that money if you'd like. Yeah, we're in a real Streets of Rage elevator over here. All right. First boss, Clown Voltron. Let's go. Come on, big buddy. Oh, this guy's chill as heck. I don't care what anybody says. It's like Rayman. It's like medieval Rayman is what it's like. Donald, don't die. Oh, wait. No, I just gave him a potion even though I'm gonna die. Donald, can you do something? God, I love Donald Duck. Thanks for the heal, big boy. Crikey. Lord. Thanks for the heal, bro. I need this battle system to stop baby holding me. I don't know if that's a word. Oh! You blew up into a million Skittles. I needed to stop baby holding me and just start letting me, like, go blaster bonkers on the abilities and such. I'm so traumatized of having so many memories of Donald Duck dying during a battle that I'm just afraid of him dying. I'm, like, constantly, my eyes will not... They just won't let go of his life meter up in the corner. I'm like, my brother is going to die shortly. Okay, heal me, Don. Donnie! Donnie's dead. See? Donnie's dead, but is Daddy dead? Crikey. All I need is just a couple abilities that I can use. Goofy, get some of that. Have some Cheetos, bro. He's not. I wish that he was more. Guy can't even feed himself. Well, I'm just gonna eat all the burgers. You wanna be my burger buddy or what? Come on down to Pain Town, Rayman. I've just about had enough of this clown kaleidoscope idiot. Strength up. Oh my god. They just took the express bus to Bonker Town right at the end there. This idiot is officially trash. I obtained a brave warrior. Well, why would I need to become one, right? I love Kingdom Hearts.
You're looking for me?
You know,
they too have been seeking the wielder of the Keyblade.
If I didn't have to work a job, I would just sit here.
Hey, why don't you come with us? We can go to other worlds on our vessel.
And just play Kingdom Hearts like a moron.
I wonder if I could find Riku and Kairi.
Yes, you can. I believe you. Is what Squall would say if I were writing.
Who knows? But we need them to come with us to help us find the thing.
Donald, why don't you swallow your food before you talk?
Go with them. Especially if you want to find your friends.
Oh, he's going to trust Squall because Squall
yeah,
is a...
I guess.
Squall is a human man. He's not going to trust the cartoon characters.
Understand?
Or?
No crowding, no shot friends, okay?
Yeah, you got to look funny, like us.
Man, Donald Duck just straight up told Sora to smile more. What?
Happy?
Ever since this key found my hand, I've never known happiness. Oh, here we go. Oh my god. Sora knows what's up. He should laugh like Tidus. Oh my god, I love this.
Okay, why not? I'll go with you guys.
Lame's Goofy.
D-Dog. And G-Man.
All for one, one for all.
D-Dog and G-Man. Oh, I love it. And then immediately it's like...
Little squirt took down that heartless.
Oh my god.
Such is the power of the Keyblade.
It's Hades and Jafar.
Why don't we turn him
into Oh, Ursula the Sea Witch.
That'll settle things quicker.
I love Ursula the Sea Witch. Oh, Cap and Hook. Looky, looky, I've got Hooky.
Bilge rats.
Oh god, I love Bilge. Oh, bibbity bobbity boo.
Enough.
I love this stuff.
The Keyblade has chosen.
Oh, here's Malfeicant. She's my favorite. She's my favorite. Angelina Jolie, yo. Okay, not actually Angelina Jolie in this game, but has everyone seen that movie Malfeicant starring Angelina Jolie? It's like legit good. I'm gonna go ahead and tell you all the truth. There's a little thing you might not know about me. My favorite Disney movie is Sleeping Beauty. My favorite Disney villain is Malfeicant. And my second favorite Disney movie is Cinderella. And I love Kenneth Branagh's live-action Cinderella movie. I went and saw that in the theater by myself twice. And I went and saw Malfeicant twice as well. It's $5. I know it's pronounced Maleficent. I like saying Malfeicant. It's funny. Right? Yeah, I love it, man. Can't stop noticing Yuffie's in Gweenles. She's, I don't know, she must do a lot of squats. Or kettlebell swings. Keep your spirits up. It's like... Yeah, why don't you try to keep your pants up, is what I would say to you. Because he's got literally four belts on. Okay, the gummy ship's outside that gate. Are you just gonna... He said our vessel, and now he just says gummy ship. Oh my god. It's like, and then this is like the stuff that the game is like ashamed to have the characters talk about.
The what?
Yeah, give me that boat. Oh, give me that wild boat. Oh, yeah? Okay. I'll kill with that. Assign spells to the shortcut buttons in the customize menu. Casting spells consumes MIP. Using ethers or striking enemies replenishes MIP. Okay, we gotcha.
Goofy, give him that other thing.
What?
Oh, yeah. Dodge roll. Oh, buddy.
So now the game is all about bonkers. I'm going to equip my abilities. Use my pressing square. It says that I'm a sword artist. Give me the best of it.
Abilities allow you to do all sorts of things, child.
Can you imagine if Goofy accidentally like got hit in the head and started talking like a normal person? And if Donald Duck swallowed the food that he's been chewing for 90 years? Well, I see big adventures coming their way. Looks like me. Yeah, there's something racist about Jiminy Cricket. Some racist history. I don't want to talk about that, though. Because, oh, look, I get all three of my buddies just strutting. Donald's too short to pop out over the thing. I wish I could put a hat on him so that he looked more like Scrooge. I'm going to go ahead and put my abilities in here. I'm going to equip that as well. Yeah, okay, that's good. Okay, so I'm going to customize Sora X button. We're going to have that. Wait, hold on. Sorry, mate. I mean, I don't want to equip that on all of them. Where's Misa dodge roll, though? Man. Oh, press the square button while moving. Okay, I knew that. How do I equip this? Sliding dash. Oh, wait. Ah, crikey. There we go. Oh my god, yeah. This is all I wanted. Why couldn't they just give me this, like, earlier in the game? Look at that form, that tumbling form. Oh, we're out of here already.
Hey, look at this mark. I wonder what it is.
Oh, that's a Trinity mark. I could have told you that. Or are they gonna just get serious? No. Okay. Well, thanks for telling me. Thanks for telling me it was a Trinity mark. Oh, buddy. Is that Dale? I love Dale. Everybody, shout everybody out in the chat. Who's your favorite, one of the Chip and Dales? Who's your favorite Chip or Dale? Let me know. You're on Daddy's Bingo. Where are you calling from? I'm one for Dale, I'm one for Chip. Gadget doesn't count. Gadget's cool. Gadget's obviously the winner. Dale. We got two for Dale, two for Chip. Three for Dale, two for Chip. Oh my god. Three for Chip. Four for Chip. Four for Dale. Five for Chip. Five for Dale. Six, seven for Chip. Six for Dale. Seven for Dale. Eight for Dale. Eight for Chip. Nine for Chip. Nine for Dale. 10 for Dale. Okay, we got Dale wins. Dale was first to 10. That's enough of that. It will hurt my head. I'm trying to read. I've got the chat on a monitor, like across the screen. Like across the room, so. Yeah. Oh, man, Chip is just, he was all quiet. Okay, I'm going to observe the battle level. Yeah, I'm going to battle them Heartless. You know, I used to be a Heartless myself. Until one day in church. That's a joke. I'm not going to talk about that. Battle level 2. Let's go to the place that's easier. Oh my god. Donald's like, I'm going to tell you how to play this game. Oh my god. I love how the Heartless have ships. The gummy ship in Kingdom Hearts 2 is like legit sweet. It's like some legit Panzer Dragoon nonsense. Whereas in this one, it's kind of like... Yeah, they give it like... Yeah, I got you. I'm going to consume the power. God, I love it. Yeah, I don't like the inverted controls. I flew into that thing because I thought it was a. Something I could collect. Oh my god, judging the 3D space is so hard. Are these the Heartless's ships? Because they're not putting up any kind of a fight at all. They're just like. The way the cursor snaps back to the middle is really frustrating. So the gummy ship is how you just kind of collect items and chill. But in Kingdom Hearts 2, it's so chill. Because the missions are, it's like actually fun to fly this dumb thing. God dang it. You cannot tell what your, like, where your ship is. Wow. I was not prepared for how difficult it is to gauge distances in this thing. Like, it's really legitimately hard. I want more of that armor. I mean, this is like some baby's first sort of stuff going on here. It's really hard to tell where these things are. Or where I am relative to them. Is that a strawberry? Oh, is that Alice in Wonder Balls? I got a new high score, everybody. Thanks. Oh, Wonderland. Disembark. The word disembark always trips me up. Shout out to, have you ever gotten confused at like a customs declaration form when traveling overseas? When it's like point of embarkation, point of disembarkation. I'm like, I embarked from one place and I'm disembarking at another, but I will be disembarking here again. Do they mean where I'll be disembarking for the purposes of customs is interested in an ultimate result, like the fact that the person's not going to be taking up permanent residence in a country? So Wonderland is the first Disney World you visit, and if I recall correctly, and that's one of the things I'm good at, is recalling correctly, this world really sucks. And it's like the worst level in like the whole Kingdom Hearts series. Almost like they made every level of this game in sequence. Like, this was like the first Disney World that they made. We're gonna shrink. Drink me. Yeah, anyway, that gummy ship sucks in Kingdom Hearts 1, but it owns in Kingdom Hearts 2, so what are you gonna do? So I get the drink me, because I can like shrink down, and I gotta go in that little door.
How did he get so small?
Because he's an idiot.
Simply too big.
Oh, yeah. Shout out in the chat. Who's actually read Alice in Wonderland, the book, the Lewis Carroll book? Who's read it?
Good morning.
Good night. I need a bit more sleep.
Wait, what do we
a
have to do?
A doorknob that sleeps?
Why don't you try the bottle over there?
Drink me. Yeah, this music. I gotta admit, it's a little bit better on the PlayStation 4. But on the PlayStation 2, it was really just kind of bloopy, bloopy little midis. At least there's kind of like a real violin in there. So.
Fire!
I used fire. That battle sucked. Those guys were chump amateurs. I got a spirit shard, everybody. Don't worry. Can I go in your door now, idiot? Just jam your key in his mouth. Right? Dodge roll. Dodge roll. So it's almost like you can sense that their level design, world design ethos in this game was, no, that's not a place, was bonkering pretty hard around just the hangout idea. the fact that you're hanging out a lot in these levels. Kriko.
See ya.
See ya. Again, you have not earned that confidence, child. Oh my god, Misa, die? Yeah, just bring me back. How did I die? I was just chilling. I wasn't trying to, like, own this game. Alright, kill this thing. Little tiny VV looking punk. Oh, bubbles. I'm picking up bubbles, everybody. Don't worry about it. Oh man, Goofy. Did you hear Goofy just like sounded the Goofy alarm? Do you want to get your face ripped off? I wish Goofy and Donald would collect my trinkets for me. I got a blaze shard. Oh, crap. Oh my god, I just like dodge rolled directly into another enemy. Oh yeah, it's an interesting decision that the enemies almost always dispense health restoring itemlets. I wouldn't call them items. You can take that lock off. The doorknob is sleeping. That's just the sort of wild hilarity you can expect from Wonderland. That book is painted. See, this is just Disney World as heck. Oh, what do these guys want? Oh, heck.
Fire!
Oh my god, he got blasted.
See ya!
Did he just not. Did he just, like, Fire! Eat my magic and not die? I just love using magic in games when they give me the option to use magic. I'm just always like, heck yeah. So as I was saying, I think their whole level design thing is based around, they're just like, what if we just make these Disney themed shoebox worlds, you know, again using that term endearingly. It's just like, it's a little shoebox world. And you get a little bit of Disney in there. You can pack enough of your favorite Disney movie into this box, and you can just root through it, you know. You can pick them through photographs and trinkets, baubles. And then the music just plays on a, what is this, like a 4 or 5 second loop? It's longer than that. And then it like dynamically shifts into battle music. Just when it feels like it. But then there are these other things, these curious things that make me sad, like this clock painted into this wall. It's just like part of the texture. It's not like an actual clock. I need to get that thing up there. Let me give me that drink. Wouldn't it be cool? There's an idea I've had for a long time is, why don't they make a Mario? Oh, I can't actually get that item that was visible there. Why can't they make a Mario where you become Super Mario? Right? Oh, did I accidentally? Oh my god. Oh my god. I need to go to the bizarre room again. I'm gonna shrink again. A Mario game? What if there was a Mario game where you can become huge and it's like kind of like this Katamari scale? Like, what is this flower that's painted on the floor doing? So I clearly need to go into this door, right? But I need to be bigger to push the bed? Man, I remember this bothering me so much when I played this game. Just having no clue what to do. Oh, now people in the chat are telling me to get big and push the bed. Yeah, thanks. It's like they teach you how to push stuff earlier in the game, and then they make it an activity. Just shrink. Itch it. We gotta wake up the doorknob, everybody. So yeah, wouldn't it be cool if there was a Mario where you get big, and it's like the world is just like different. Like you're just like, you grow, but you grow like dynamically, and there's like two scales of world. Oh, there's Alice. My good friend Alice. Again, we're in a little shoebox here. I think that's the whole point, though. It's like a house of cards. You can see the corners and the walls.
Court is now in session!
I'm on trial? But why?
Majesty, the Queen of Hearts, presiding.
So, in the original book, Alice in Wonderland,
this
contains
girl
a lot
is
of
the culprit.
References
no
to the
doubt about it.
Politics of
and
the day.
And the reason is... Because I say
which
so,
were
that's
diluted further in the
so
name
unfair.
Of jazzy cartoon nonsense
well, have
in
you
the
anything
film.
To say in your defense?
And
of course, I've done
this presentation
nothing
in the
wrong.
Game is a copy
you
of a copy
queen,
of a copy.
But I'm afraid that doesn't give you the right.
I'm on trial.
So
I don't know why.
So mean.
Doesn't
silence.
Give you the right to be so mean.
You
silence
dare
off their head.
Me?
It's a
guys,
whole lot of.
We should help her out.
Whole lot of nonsense.
We're outsiders, so wouldn't that be muddling?
Oh, yeah.
And that's
it's amazing that Goofy says, wouldn't that be muddling, and Donald Duck corrects him and says, don't you mean meddling? Like, Donald Duck with a voice like he's got is going to correct one guy's vowel. I mean, come on.
Off with her head!
No, no! Oh,
yeah, take
please.
It off.
Hold it right there!
Who are you? How dare you interfere with my culprit?
I'm here to solve her problems.
Excuse me, but we know who the real culprit is.
Uh-huh. It's the Heartland.
Anyway, she's not the one you're looking for.
That's
yeah, they're
nonsense.
Not allowed to meddle with proof? The affairs. It's kind of, they got like a prime directive Star Trek thing going on. Which makes me wonder, oh yeah, wow, it's like immediate snap from cutscene to gather evidence. I gotta go get evidence. Okay, yeah. Oh, this part sucks, because I just, like, go around. The world's, like, picking things up. Let's go ahead and save the big boy game. So it's like, it says to me that in this world, in this Alice in Wonderland world, like, Alice's trial is just happening over and over again. Just over and over again. And yes, everyone, Haley Joel Osment is voicing Sora in Kingdom Hearts 3. Not is. I mean, he already did. I mean, obviously the game's done. Or is it? Is it done? Are they trying to hide something from us? Haley Joel Osment, 30 years old now. Voicing this 15-year-old character. So I need to, like, grab a bunch of trash. Oh, crikey. Okay, hold on. Maybe I gotta get small again. Hold on. Drink me. Let's see what we got. So this book is something, right? Crikey. I realize these things that are like painted into the ground are like part of something. It's like it's a curious first world for this game to have. Because, I mean, it's curious that the first world is one whose gimmick is to have a bunch of flat stuff. Because, I mean, the rest of the game kind of has a lot of zones that kind of feel like you're inside of boxes. This game is, again, I'm not complaining because I grew up in the 80s and 90s. And I played so many video games that tell you absolutely nothing. But this game is real bad at telling you what to do. Whatever, though. Oh, it's the cheese cat. Ah, cheese cat, bro. This cat is ridiculous. I'm sorry. I don't believe that this cat could exist in real life. I'm just gonna say, I just don't think he's real. A cat that can disappear. Oh my god. What did Alice do, though? 4 pieces of evidence. 3 are a cinch to find. The 4th is tricky. Okay. Literally, the first time somebody in the game tells you what to do, it's the cheese cat who... Wow, that guy was born to die. Did you see that? The first time the game has somebody tell you what to do, it's literally a famously enigmatic character who speaks in riddles. Gotta hit this plant.
Oh. Come on.
You want one? Crikey. So I'm in this forest. I remember this forest being just like... It's just really flat, obviously. Come on, are you guys gonna fight? Goofy just kind of looks like a loser, just like shielding around everywhere. I'm glad I'm making some cash out of this deal, at least. This is a Trinity mark. Is it a tiny box? Ooh. Oh, let me go in and get that cash real quick. Does everybody love this music or what? Oh, hey guys. So here's my, you want to talk? They all want ether. Everybody wants something. These flowers don't talk to me unless they want something. Oh my god, you punks. Oh, Goofy just yelled. Did you hear that? You're not in trouble till you yell. Where's the camera at? Okay, there we go. Hello? Monsters? I did it. Oh god. So I remember, I don't actually need that health, but I went and got it anyway. I remember just despising the platforming here. Wait, what? Let me open this one. It's an antenna, everybody. Thank you. So I remember just being like, having a real, oh, so that's how it's going to be kind of moment with the platforming in this section. Because it's like, the platforms are all like the exact distance you can jump with no subtlety. It's too big to eat. Who cares? And they don't let you move the camera when you're in proximity to certain objects. Give me whatever's in there. 16, 17, and 18 just joylessly returned to their home. I don't even get to see the Dalmatians. I'm just assured that there were 3 dogs stuffed in that box. Hey, what's up, bro? Is that really why you came here, friend? Oh, give me that box. I obtained a stench. I know how to get one of those without playing this video game. I know I can go up to that bookshelf. Is that one of the evidences? Yes or no? Someone tell me. Me start to get tired is all I'm going to say about what's happening right now in this video game. Is, me start to feel the sleepy time. It's that time of day when I gotta have a cup of coffee number 6. I quit coffee for like 3 months last year. It's easy. Anybody can do it. But I'm back. I'm back. But my cup is empty. It used to be one of those days my cup runneth over. Now it runneth out of coffee. Okay. What else do I need? Someone, please. Help. Give me a potion. Yeah, take one. Do I not have a potion? How do I give this man a potion? Am I just completely wildly out of potion? Oh. I keep pressing the button that should be jump to jump. Yeah? You gonna hit me or are you just gonna stand there? Well, Goofy and Donald are just like chilling downstairs. I give those kids something to do. Oh, hey, they're up. How you boys doing? Donald? Yeah, Donald was having a little bit of a fit. Did you see that? I want to go up there, right? And over there. Well, I'm glad we all know what to do. See, that's too far. Gauging the distance between any of these platforms here is just straight up murder nightmare. It's like having a dream where you killed somebody, you know? Goofy? Gorsh, he is stuck between dimensions. Where did me go? Is it not possible to get up there? This platform, the bottom of it is just kind of painted with the texture. Oh my god, I don't know what to do. It's too big to eat. How do I get a potion? Where are there potions for me to get? Is there a shop? Will one of these card guys sell me a potion? You got a potion, bro? I'm sorry you got mixed up in this nonsense. Is that like the most honest thing an NPC ever said to a video game character? Yeah, I don't believe I have a potion. Wait. I have a mega potion and 2 high potions. I have a bunch of trash in this bucket. No, I want to give it to him. Will this guy take a high potion? Or is a high potion too fancy for him?
This should help.
No, he wants a regular potion. He doesn't want a high potion. How do I get a potion? Do I just have to fight monsters until I get one? Because that is straight up wild. Man. This is just one of those cases of a game where bug testers don't catch it. Bug testers won't catch it, and the game designers, level designers won't catch it, but it's like, that's kind of a nonsense thing. What if the player doesn't have any potions? Nobody asks that question. Take a drink. The Blue Trinity may give me a potion, someone is saying in the chat. I mean, I don't... What about this Green Trinity? Can I not do a Green Trinity yet? I will say these loading times are... The loading times are good. What is the evidence I need? What do I need? I'm gonna kill these guys because maybe they'll give me potions. I leveled up though. So. Oh, there was a big money there. Did you see that? I have enough money to buy some stuff. Oh man. Come on, freak.
Come on.
Oh yeah, Sora's starting to get confident. He's no hungry anymore, that's good. Alright, I gotta find this Blue Trinity. Oh, the money disappeared. Man, you guys need to all chill. I love how Goofy just kind of yells during the battles. He doesn't need words. He can say words if he wants, but he doesn't care. Oh my god, these fools. Donald is straight up owned. You okay, bro? Ah, he'll be alright. He's back. Ladies and gentlemen, Donald Duck is back. Trinity, let's go. Let's see what the power of friendship can do this time. Oh yeah. Give me all of that. Potion and an ether. Okay. Give me that. Footprints. Okay. Okay, so... So, we got the, we got footprints and stench. There's four pieces of evidence.
Come on.
Oh, can't talk to the flower while there's monsters about. God, Donald is dead again. If Donald's dead, then Daddy's dead.
Here.
Make me bigger, idiot. Oh, I'm a big, big boy in a tiny, tiny world. Okay, so I can spend this trash. Crikey. I can't move the camera. Can't do much. Okay. So I don't actually know where I'm supposed to spin this thing. Oh wait, there we go. Okay. Acorn make me shrinky. That's good. Now I need to go up there. Wait, what? Oh, crikey. I definitely was not done in that room yet. Man. Now I need to get another potion in order to, like, get big again. Oh, Krikerino. That blue trinity never comes back, I take it. Lord. Okay, so what exactly is necessary for getting the evidence to finish this level? Alice in Wonderland, the video game, huh? I need that treasure. Can't make that jump, though. Should I just go present the two pieces of evidence that I have? I unlock Blizzard if I do it right. I want Blizzard. Is there a way to get it? I want all the magic is the problem. What about this dumb rabbit? Do you have anything to say for yourself, moron? Huh? Huh? Oh. Okay. All right, let's kill. Bring forth my evidence. Mm-hmm. Yeah, like, I love how what just happened is, like, just completely inscrutable. Like, I have no idea. Yeah, I don't care. Oh, it's a heartless. Yeah, that's crazy. Watch it, Donald Duck. I find it hard to believe he pronounced that word correctly because of the shape of his mouth. Yeah, turn the wheel. I wanted all the evidence. Let's fight. I'm gonna not hit that. Oh, this owns. You piece of freak. Die. Oh, we get to hear the queen's voice. She's calling me a fool. I'm gonna burn you, idiot. I'm just gonna keep hitting this thing. Oh man, I'm targeting the wrong thing. There we go. This is the thrills. This is the thrills you want when you play Kingdom Hearts. Because I'm literally in the Kingdom of Hearts right now. Man, these guys are getting turned into paper. Am I going to have to fight the full deck here? What is this? Ace of Spades. Oh, I don't have any items which can be used. Goofy Donald, do you guys want to do this for me? Oh, wait. Oh, there you are. Did they just get up? This sucks, bro. Fire. Donald, can you just heal me? Oh my god. This is straight up precarious. Ugh. Alright, let's do this again. I know what to do. I just... Oh no, do I have to do the whole stupid trial again? Yeah, let's kill. I wanted to kill the whole deck of cards. So it's like there's two, now it's one, now it's five. I'm just gonna grab that, yeah. Yeah, I got you. Oh, I was pressing the button so furiously. I wanted to kill the full deck. I wanted to go 52, as they call it. How conveniently video gamey for stuff to just disappear. So there's a goal going on here, which is to destroy this tower. But it's like, the camera angle makes it really hard to see it. It's like, am I supposed to hit that thing? Oh my god, this guy's just gonna keep... Donald, can you cure me, bro? Oh my god, for God's sake. Oh, this sucks. I just have to keep hitting that thing. Why can't Donald just heal me? Why not? Heal me, Donald. Oh, yeah, bring forth the evidence. Yeah. We're gonna try this one more time. Some one thing I could do is, once again, I used my key to strike. We're gonna choose this one. Yeah, I don't care. I know there's at least something in there that weirds her out. I mean, I feel like that's the right one to choose. I'm just gonna use my dodge roll a lot more, is what I'm gonna do. And it's like, they just like raise this cage up there, and that's basically their whole, ah, crikey. Donald Duck just immediately, no, don't hit him. Donald's gonna straight up die. Donald the dying duck, right? Basically, you just gotta dodge roll a lot. Oh, that's not a wheel. Okay. She should try calling her employees, like, not calling them fools. They might be more inspired to help her out. What? All my health just disappeared. Oh my lord, will you leave me alone? Donald, come back from the life of death. I wish Donald weren't dead. Also, I wish Daddy weren't dead. That's it. Give me that life. Give me the taste. What? These guys, Goofy is just soldiering, dude. So, I really, like, I don't want to hate on Donald because he's, like, literally my best friend. But why does he die, like, all the time? Why does he die every 2 seconds? Owned. More like she Muppet have gotten kidnapped. Because she's a Muppet. Stop calling everyone fools. Wait, were there five? Were those five aces? Donald is legit my best friend, but I don't like that he dies. You know what? I've got to go, everybody. I got to finish making my video about Kingdom Hearts. But I'll be back with more Kingdom Hearts. Why would we stop playing this game, right? Like, seriously, why would I stop playing this? I'm not bailing, everyone. I'm leaving because I've got to actually make a video. I've got to capture some cutscenes from some of the other Kingdom Hearts games. And then I've got to just splice them under my voiceover. Everybody be ready for my sweet video, which is just me talking about Kingdom Hearts. Wow. I'm not going to do it because the Queen said so. I'm going to do it because the red-eyed rabbit told me to. Man, that rabbit. Dude, I hate to say this, but that rabbit is so high, dude. Like, look at him. Like, seriously. I mean, look. I mean, come on. And then Donald is, speaking of red eyes, right? Donald's like, he's high on something else. He's high on, like, NyQuil. He's got those blue eyes. It's like, what is that, man? What's, like, I know what red eyes means, but what does blue eyes mean? That's weird. Anyway, he's low. Yeah, Kyle Furson, you win. That's what he is. He's not high, he's low. Well, thanks for tuning in, Kotaku.com. Tonight, I go home, and I go to sleep. Tomorrow, I'm going to see the film Glass, starring Samuel L. Jackson and Bruce Willboy. I'm going to have a good time watching that. However, I'm going to make this Kingdom Hearts video first. I just want to hang out with these buddies all day. I just accidentally noticed Sora's got, like, those pants make it look like he's got a real beef butt, doesn't it? It's just a... Anyway, I don't know what I'm going to do, because I would just sit here all day and talk about superficial details. The Queen is looking down. What's she looking at? Deep in thought. Anyway, that's all I got. Goodbye. Goodbye for now.